despite the Act Against Discrimination and Unemployment Opportunities for Persons with Living with Disabilities, most of them still find themselves passed over for jobs. Now, as Nigeria joins the world to commemorate this year's International Day of Persons with Disability, the Association of the Blind in Abuja want government to ensure strict adherence to full implementation of the Act to ensure their inclusiveness in the society. The observance of the day aims to promote an understanding on disability issues and mobilize support for the dignity, rights, and well-being of persons with disabilities. This year's theme, Building Better, both a disability-inclusive, accessible, and sustainable post-COVID-19 world. Sadly, only a few countries have adequate mechanisms in place to respond fully to the needs of people with disabilities.
It's not that I don't get interviews, but immediately they say I'm on the wheels. They give me one story or the other. I even went as low as, even if it's 40,000 naira, I don't mind. I just have to take care of my family.
It's evident from the research finding that most of the public and private infrastructures in FCT are not physically accessible for persons with disability. None of them has disability-friendly policies and address the communication needs of persons with disability. A more inclusive society. Therefore, we urge the government institutions to implement the 5% as stipulated by the National Disability Act.
Well, with me in the studio is the Executive Director, Center for Citizens with Disabilities, David Anyeli. Thank you so much for joining us.
I'm glad to be here.
Now, you heard those people we interviewed talking about their grievance, what they have experienced as a result of their disability. The inclusion of people with disability is still a major issue over the years.
Yeah, we are worried. Since the foundation of this country, state systems are designed at the exclusion of people with disabilities. It took us 18 good years for us to secure the assent of President on the Discrimination Against Persons with Disabilities Prohibition Act. We expect full commitment thereafter in terms of operationalization and implementation. Just this year, after 15 months of its passage, that the Commission on Persons with Disabilities was established. As I speak to you, the names of the members of the board of the commission is still lying at the National Assembly for scrutiny. The challenge people with disabilities are facing in this country is state-induced. The reason is simple. State operations are designed at exclusion. So when you see a person with disabilities begging on the street, when you see a person with disabilities crying on the street, when you see families of people with disabilities groaning on how to take care of their own disability, you should see a state-induced pain, a state-induced agony, a state-induced discrimination, isolation, and other harmful practices that is pervasive across the system of federation. So we are worried. The Act provides for 5% employment opportunity. Yet, you see programs, there was this program being rolled out, employment of 74,000 people across the, the system of federation. The Minister for State for Employment, I'm talking about Festus Keyamo, was silent on the 5% allocation for people with disabilities. That's how bad it is.
Have you engaged him in this respect?
Is it, this is a law signed by the president during the June 12th presidential address. He made it specific that all ministerial departments should take measures to ensure that they engage and ensure employment of people with disabilities. Who else would tell them? If the president tells them, am I the one that will equally counter what the president has said? Do I need to do advocacy visits or that? A president address, a president instruction, a president directives. Yet, we are struggling to get access, to get, to secure participation on equal basis with others. That is the situation we find ourselves.
Well, if the Center for Citizens with Disability, which you handle, visits the Minister of State for Employment to remind him.
We have in the past, written, sought for audience. Not only him, others. The moment they hear disability, the next thing they hear is, discrimination. The next thing is stigma. The next thing is isolation. The next thing is how do we, discard this group of people. Anytime organization of persons with disabilities want to have interface with a politician or state official, the first thing that will come to his or her mind is how to give charity Oh, I don't have money to give to them. Oh, they are looking for money. Oh, even a state official that is owed a 12-year salary, we only believe that he's coming to give us money. Even when you're asking, let's discuss issues that will enhance, you know, inclusive governance within the system. That is the situation we find ourselves. That is worrisome.
Okay, so in all of these situations now, let's look at the COVID-19 pandemic. How did it affect people living with disabilities?
During the lockdown, occasioned by COVID-19, it was people with disabilities that suffered most. The reason is simple. You listen to governors, you listen to presidential task force on COVID-19, they hardly make statement that, you know, demonstrate that people with disabilities are of concern to them, knowing fully well that they pay dearly for the consequences of this lockdown. It is even made worse during the ease of lockdown guidelines released by different groups, different, you know, organizations, institutions, ministry, department. There was no mention of how people with disabilities will, you know, get relief or get protected with the guideline, COVID-19 ease of lockdown guideline. To the extent that the Honorable Minister of Aviation issued his guideline without making provision on access to aircraft in this country. As I speak to you, if you are on wheelchair and you want to access any aircraft in this country, just go to any of the, beyond MM2, the rest of the airport, local airport in this country, there is no access. So they will carry you like a sack bag and lift you to the aircraft. So we read it, we asked, we demanded, we said include, make provision, deaf ear. I'm talking about Saraki, the Minister for Aviation. Yeah. I don't want to talk about Honorable Chibike Amechi, who is managing our railway sector. And he's building railway every day, borrowing money in my head at the exclusion of people with disabilities. So you build a railway, people with disabilities will not access those railway. As if the ministers are immune from getting disability. No minister, no matter how highly placed, from the presidency to any local person at the local government, is immune from getting disability. The question is, if it happens to you, what will you do? So when we are shouting, when we are asking, when we are saying government should take measure to protect its own people with disabilities, we are asking you that is not with disability. If it occurred to you now, what will you do? That is the situation we find ourselves. And we are using this program, this, you know, today's occasion, to draw attention of all, the disability issues is not for those people begging on the street. Disability issues are not people with disabilities who are. Disability issues are about you.
The mindsets.
You, that is not with disability today. If it happens to you, what will you do? If it happens to your sibling, if it happens to your brother, what will you do? So, you know, inclusive protection is what we're asking for. As I speak to you, bros, any day you hear attack, either by Boko Haram or bandits, whatever, beyond the people that were massacred or people that were killed, are people that suffer disability. Look at the NSAS saga at the toll gate. They are not talking about those that suffer disability. If you go to all the public hearings, you know, venues, you see people who are coming with different forms of disability occasioned by the state. What we are saying is that the problem people with disabilities are facing today is state-induced. The moment the Nigerians demand for accountability on the part of the government on how they have taken care of people with disabilities in all these facets of governance in this country, the earlier that government will be responsible in addressing disability issues.
Okay, so in all of this, now how does this place Nigeria on the map of the world now in terms of disability issues?
You know, Nigeria has the highest concentration of poor people in the world. What that means is that Nigeria has the highest concentration of people with disabilities in the world because poverty causes disability and disability causes poverty. What that means is that Nigeria is not being accorded the kind of, you know, Nigerians with disabilities are not being accorded the kind of protection they desire across the world. Nigeria is not faring better. Yes, the president signed the Disability Act. Yes, the National Commission for Persons with Disabilities have been established. But how does that translate to better living for that person with disability in Ogbomosho, that person with disability in Kafancha, that person with disability in Daura? How does that improve his living condition? A classical example, as I speak to you, many states are planning for local government elections. The act provides that, you know, state institutions, people with disabilities should be encouraged to participate in political activities. Can you imagine? Even states like Kaduna State, no disability law. As the local government election is being planned, The chairman of the election management body in Abia State, Professor Mkpa Agonpa, has no clue on how people civility will participate in the election. And if you ask him, sir, I don't have money. What do you want me to do? This and that. That's how they think the situation in this country. And that is why I'm glad that TVC, from time to time, flag this issue to draw attention of all. That this is not how to treat a citizen. This is not how to treat marginalized population. This is not how to treat people that are weak in society. Because Nigeria is not being measured by the number of political appointees we have.
Yeah.
Nigeria is being measured by the level of their care to vulnerable groups, in particular, people with disabilities.
All right, so as the world commemorates this year's International Day of Persons with Disability, in all of this now, what suggestions will you give to governments? Yes, the act has not been implemented to the latter at all, as you have said. But in all of this now, what would you say the president should do to ensure that there's inclusion of people living with disabilities, not just from the public sector, but also in the private sector as well?
First is, President Muhammad Buhari should direct the Minister for Information, Chief Lai Mohammed, to operationalize Section 2 of the Discrimination Against Persons with Disability Prohibition Act, which demand from the ministry that they should create awareness on success stories, on the right, dignity, and contribution of people with disabilities in nation building. By so doing, every Nigerian will know that people with disabilities' rights are being prioritized by the government. By so doing, people will know that government is interested on issues of people with disabilities. We are asking the private sector to conduct audit of their services and their processes, including their environment, to identify disability gap. Most private sectors' infrastructures are not accessible to people with disabilities. So if you want to enter a typical bank in Nigeria, there is no access for someone in a wheelchair. When you want to open an account, they will collect money from you. But the day you say you want to come to the bank to collect the money, they see you as a security risk because either you're on clutches or you're on wheelchair. So when private sector conduct audit of their services, conduct audit of their infrastructure, conduct audits of their policies to identify disability gap, by so doing, they will know where they are and be able to take measures to close it. Let me tell you, the Act provides monitoring of 5 years to ensure all public buildings in this country are disability friendly. Without that, there are different fines,
all right,
you know, that has been provided for those that contravene the provisions of the law.
All right, Executive Director, Center for Citizens with Disability, David Anyeli, thank you so much for joining us at this point.
I'm grateful.